Hardball. You can't just take some Korean-made velveteen primate and call it Rupert. Now, come on, this is all time we could be using to find Rupert's kidnappers.
Look, I may as well come clean with you. Rupert wasn't kidnapped. What the hell's up with these rolling blackouts?
Well, since Lois is the mayor, I'm allowed to reroute all the town's electricity.
What'd you do that for?
So I could reanimate the corpse of Jim Verney.
Howdy, Vern. This is some dadgum nice house you got here, Vern. That's Vern, 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 Vern.
I just like... When you lose... There's so much... You...
Who is this?
It's Brian.
It's Brian! Oh, Brian. Probably RSVPing about Meg's party. Hello, Brian.
Hi, Stewie.
What can I do for you?
I'm coming to Meg's party.
Oh, splendid. Just give your information to Mrs. Pennyapple. Hello! Again? Shall I put you down for two, Brendan?
Brian.
Ryan?
Brian.
Mitchell?
What?
Goodbye!
Stan, I need $50. They're selling a biopsy of Celine Dion's uterus on eBay. The hell kind of dog is that? I was gonna ask the same thing.
Oh, that's our alien, Roger. He lives in our attic, but nobody can know. And don't tell anybody about our attic.
Well, it's actually Brian I need to talk to you about.
Boy, he's a hell of a guy, isn't he? I mean, Quagmire's a lot of fun at a party, but, you know, he's so horny all the time, I feel like I can't trust him. Cleveland's a great guy, but he's got a mustache, so you gotta wonder what he's hiding. Joe's a cripple, so for obvious reasons, I can't trust him. But Brian? Brian's solid.
Are you sure you didn't just sleep on it, Funny?
Does this look like I slept on it, Funny? I'm gonna tell Mom. Mom!
You are not going anywhere. I finally have a date with Miss Emily tomorrow, and I'm not gonna let you or anybody else get in my way until I have seen every inch of her naked.
Do you even hear yourself? And what am I supposed to do about my arm?
Is your dad around?
Oh, he's off at his Stitch and Bitch Club. I'm glad you stopped by, though. My dad wanted me to tell you he would be thrilled if you and Lois would join us as his guests at the Naval Ball.
Yeah, that'd be great. Hey, remember when we met him the other day and he danced for a while?
Yeah, that was so funny, man.
Listen, I'm here to get my money back for that ham radio.
Whoa. Slow down there, partner. All sales are final.
Yeah, but you were Agamemnon with me during the sale.
What?
I just saw that word somewhere. I wanted to use it.
Look, Peter, why don't you just go home before you get hurt?
Well, I'm clearly not the only one who was dissatisfied with his purchase. Whoever bought that baby from you obviously didn't want it.
Okay, thank you. Did you wash my car like I asked?
No, but I hit it with a rock.
Okay, thanks.
Brian, I think my jaw is falling off.
Stewie, what is happening to this thing?
Oh, yeah, turns out the clones aren't too stable, Brian. I've been having some trouble with mine, too.
Maybe you could do some damn laundry once in a while.
What?
What?
Wow, Mom, is that a new purse?
Yeah, that looks pretty expensive.
Well, don't tell anybody, Brian, but I was a little naughty. I may have dipped into the tax surplus.
I can't believe they're brainwashing kids like Chris to serve in the military.
Ah, yes, the bottom 10% of our high school class is off to fight another battle.
You stole that from The Onion.
What?
You stole that. I read that in The Onion about the war in Iraq.
Well, if that's true, then I'd say they've got some sharp cookies over at the, what is it again? The Onion?
So if I go up to your room right now, I'm not going to find a copy of The Onion, right?
No.
Oh, my God. Peter, it's beautiful. Is it a blood diamond?
Oh, the bloodiest. The two kids who found it were forced to murder each other.
Oh, Peter, I love it.
Hey, you want to watch a DVD of the murder while we do it?
Come on, dudes, let's go exercise!
Exercise!
Yeah!
I'm gonna do sit-ups till I crap myself.
I can't believe it. Joe just dumped us. He's gone.
And all we got to remember him by are his old legs.
Okay.
Spread your tiny wings and fly away.
I'll touch the flower with your cape on a day.
Come on, man, sing along. You know it. You didn't write it, but you know it, bitch.
The one I love forever is untrue.
I would like for you to sleep with me in my bed. And this is not about sex, it's about sleep.
No, I totally get it, Peter. Snuggling is a basic human need.
Right, I mean, who says that the body next to you has to be male or female or whatever?
Or alive.
Yeah, well, no, but yeah.
I suppose they are.
You know what else? I picked out a sexy little Jewish outfit for you at the store.
What is that?
Oh, my God, Lois, if you put on this long, thick dress right now, I will lose it.
Peter, I'm not wearing that thing.
And if you put this shawl over your head... Ooh, do you have any clunky, unfit...
Look at that, Brian. Cleveland is back living across the street. Cleveland left Cohog quite some time ago, yet we only just recently entered reverse time.
So? What does that mean?
Well, it suggests that time may not simply be flowing backwards. It may, in fact, be accelerating.
Accelerating? Why would that be happening?
I'm not sure.
That's not bad.
Better than mine.
Does he have an idea, or do I have to come up with it myself?
He's got an idea, but it's not quite there.
I'd have to give it to Janet Reno, because I've always had this business plan for home delivery of prescription medications, and that seems like it's more her market.
This is stupid. I want to talk about vaginas!
Don't be too hard on yourself, Peter. We all do things that we're not proud of.
Well, I am going to change. You hear me, Meg? If you come out of this, I am going to treat you like a princess for the rest of your life. Because I've been a worse father than Abraham.
You want to tell me what the fuck that was?
It's true. You never want to do anything with me. But the monkey's been taking me to all the fun places I like. And he's been helping me with all my homework. He helped me get an A in algebra.
How did the monkey know you needed help with algebra?
Because he has!
Look, you aren't going to shoot us in the eye, are you, Peter?
Oh, no, Joe. I wouldn't try to shoot you in the eye.
A lot of shoes.
We're growing shoes.
A lot of rice.
It's also nice. Peter, it was really close to my eye.
Relax, Joe. I'm nowhere near your eye. Hey, Joe, open your eye.
Holy crap.
Yeah, holy crap. So, you here for the Death Star assault?
Yeah, I can't wait. How about you?
Well, no, I can't really.
Oh, yeah, because of that.
The chair.
The chair, yeah.
Yeah, so I'll just be here making sandwiches for when you guys get back.
Oh, well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Chris, I can't believe you knew about this. That's terrible. Why would you even date a girl like that?
Well, because I thought she'd be like you.
Like me?
Well, you gotta admit, Mom, she does look a lot like you. I mean, I just look at you and Dad, you know? He's a complete train wreck, and you put up with him.
Oh, hi.
Oh, hey, I just came to say, you know, in a couple of years, something's gonna come along called Sesame Street, and I know the name makes it sound Asian, but it's not, and it's gonna blow your mind. The hell with it. The real reason I ran over here is because I wanted to do this.
This is an 18th century Rhode Island ship token. This thing's gotta be worth 50 grand.
50 grand? Oh my God! I can finally afford that operation to swap my vocal cords with Patrick Stewart.
Hey, Lois. Sorry about the mess in the upstairs bathroom this morning. My post-sex peace stream forked in half last night and got everywhere.
Oh, come on! Those kinds of jokes aren't helping!
What do you want me to say? You're being silly. I mean, Jerome and I dated over 12 inches ago. Inches.
What did I just say?
I'm sorry. Okay, look, just relax. You're my husband, and I love you. So just put Jerome out of your head.
You remember what you said about Lois's potatoes are rotten?
Huh. Didn't think anybody heard that. Wish you'd laughed at the time.
But what the hell happened to my car? Well, I don't know, man. But the good news is that it doesn't look all that bad, Brian. It's just it's that spot right there that's upsetting you, right?
I've got a few connections in the back. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah, that's funny. If there's one onion on that salad, you can forget the $1.80 tip. You need to live.
I'm sorry, you guys. This is all my fault. I never should have brought you on the space shuttle. You were right. I am stupid.
Hello up there.
Hello?
You know that, right? Just in case, I'll say it again. I love you.
Oh, you are just so cute, sweetie. Look at that little foot. I'm gonna eat that foot. Give me that foot.
don't eat my foot. Oh, God. Oh, it is so hard to find funny women, and you are hilarious. Oh, you're like a female Bonnie Hunt.
Powerful stuff. You'd have to be made of stone not to feel saddened by that.
Boy, Quagmire, I'm really sorry they fired you. I feel like this is partially my fault.
Now, Peter, it's perfectly normal to siphon jet fuel from an active runway with the intention of flying a pickup truck.
Look, I know I caused a lot of trouble, but my redneck days are over. No more crotch shots of me getting out of a car.
You were going too sexy in a 35 zone. I'll need to see your driver's license.
What? Joe, what the hell's wrong with you? It's me, Quagmire.
Glenda Vagmire. Well, how would you like to spend 4 hours desperately trying to give me a muscular soldier?
What the hell, you weirdo?
I'm just having fun. I've spent the last 15 years gathering information on him. And it's all here. Every crime he's committed, every associate he's had...
Oh, look, Briggs was all-county JV swimming.
I don't just focus on the negative.
Joe, your 25-year-old son and your baby daughter share a room just so you can keep a weirdo, beautiful mind room?
You want me to drag my sack across your face?
What?
I'm sorry. When one of my lady friends is upset, that's how I cheer. Listen, Peter, I this is all I know. I'm not very good in these types of situations.
Yeah, Quagmire, I know your heart's in the right place, but I need to sort this out for myself.
Yeah, that was so hot.
Just like we always do.
Now take off each other's clothes.
Oh, God, I'm so excited for gay sex.
Me too. Your body makes me so horny.
Shut up and...
Quagmire, it's so awesome that you could come over after work today.
I know, I'm so psyched. Hey, let's make some Kool-Aid.
No, we gotta wait for Lois to do it.
No, we don't. I know how to make Kool-Aid.
No, Quagmire, we're not supposed to...
I'm home, Peter. Oh, hi, Glenn.
I don't get it. You've gained 20.